Hello, React Native developers. I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. At App.js, we introduced our work on React Native Web GPU, and we saw strong appetite from industry friends. We immediately understood that we need to design a short path to a publicly available release. So here it is, React Native Web GPU is now available as a technical preview. This means that this is still very much a work in progress. We need to massage the octopus a little bit more, and we will, but this technical preview will enable early adopters to get a sense of the new range of user experiences that can be built with React Native Web GPU. So how does it work? Well, just like on the web, you get a Canva, you get its reference, and from it, you can synchronously access a web GPU context as well as the Canva width and size. This means that you can copy-paste directly examples from the web onto React Native. And like in Google Chrome, where you get these nice validation errors and warnings, we provide the same in React Native Web GPU. We are building this module under three use cases. First, we are building it for us. It's all about React Native Skia. We are using Dawn, the C++ implementation of Web GPU from Google, and this project is enabling us to eventually migrate to Skia Graphite, a new backend for Skia for modern GPU APIs. This new backend is slowly but surely getting deployed to all Google Chrome users, and we are setting ourselves up to eventually migrate to Skia Graphite as well. This will enable us to eventually provide a graphical stack to React Native developers that is completely symmetrical to Google Chrome. So Skia needs Web GPU, but Web GPU needs Skia as well. We think that 3D developers are going to really enjoy using React Native Skia with Web GPU to build advanced 2D textures, leveraging some of the Skia codecs for images and videos, as well as the powerful text layout engine from Skia. So that's use case number one. We are building it for us, but we are also building it for you. By exposing the Web GPU API to JavaScript, we think that people are going to build incredible 3D experiences as well as making artistic explorations. And we also think that a strong area of exploration is going to be running 3GS powered Web GPU apps onto React Native. And finally, beyond graphics, use case number three, we think that developers are going to use Web GPU to run on-device machine learning models and build incredible experiences in React Native. With this module, we really wanted to keep the symmetry with the web. You can access the Web GPU context synchronously as well as the width and height of the Canva. So you can just copy-paste example from the web onto React Native. If you are new to React Native, this might feel very obvious. If you are a veteran, you might notice that this is the very first time that a graphical library in React Native is offering such a model. And we think that this Canva model is going to be extremely useful in other graphic libraries. In fact, we are already actively working in integrating it into React Native Skia. And this great design has been built by Krzysztof Piaskowy from Software Mansion.
I am Krzysztof Piaskowy. I am React Native Reanimated Maintainer at Software Mansion. Recently, I joined forces with William to help him with Web GPU platform integration. Thanks to William, we were able to achieve the same API as the web version.
You can simply copy-paste an existing web example and run it in your mobile application without any additional effort. You can synchronously access the Web GPU canvas from the React Native component, as well as the width and height. This approach to Canvas is similar to the Web API. We hope to set the standard for other Canvas-based libraries, such as Skia and others. Moreover, we are currently working on integration with Reanimated and Worklets. This will allow us to use Web GPU context on any thread, including the one spawned by developers.
Writing your own shaders can be challenging. At Software Mansion, we want to help you with this. That's why we are currently working on a new library called TypeGPU. We are planning to release it very soon. TypeGPU allows you to write type-safe shaders with more confidence and ease. Additionally, it helps you eliminate unnecessary boilerplate code from your codebase. Thanks. Back to you, William.
Like Christoph mentioned, with this new Canva API, we stumbled on a generic Canva API that we think is useful beyond React Native Web GPU. In React Native Skia, we are already working on integrating it, and we think it can also benefit other graphical libraries in React Native. Now, we hope that you'll have tons of fun using React Native Web GPU, but we also had tons of fun building it. First, we are using Dawn from Google, and just like for Skia, they have incredible stewardship on their open source projects, and it's really fun to work with, and we're getting great support from the teams at Google. Now, to build a web GPU binding, you need to build two interoperability layers. First, from JavaScript to C++, and then from the C++ data structures to web GPU descriptors. For level one, we code generate the C++ code from the TypeScript definition. And for level two, we use an implementation from Dawn. So by using code generation and the Dawn implementation, this gives us a sense of safety that we're sitting on strong shoulders. For layer one, you might notice this completely transparent conversion from JavaScript to C++. You don't even need to think about it. This is using an early version of a new API to be released quite soon called Nitro Modules from Margiello. And we think that this new project, Nitro Modules, is setting a new standard for what it means to build native modules in React Native. And we're enjoying using it a lot, and we think that many library developers are going to enjoy it as well. We also had a lot of fun testing the module. We do something really cool. First, we run our whole test suite on Google Chrome to get the expected images and values. This ensures that our test suite is correct. And from there, we can run the identical test suite on iOS and Android in React Native to make sure that we are being correct here. And this test-driven development approach has been very joyful. And that's the first technical preview of React Native Web GPU. We hope that you'll have as much fun using it as we did building it. Thank you to the W3C committee and all its members for building such a great standard and enabling us to get so much leverage out of it. Thank you, Google, for building these incredible open source projects with Dawn and Skia. This is setting us up to be able to offer React Native developers a graphical stack that is symmetric to Google Chrome in React Native, and we're very excited about this quest for symmetry with the web. As for anything React Native related, this project is a result of a collaboration between different industry players, from Shopify, who's driving the vision and supporting it, to Software Mansion, who's building this incredible Canva API that we think is going to be useful for libraries even outside Web GPU, and Margiello, who's redefining what it means to build a native module in React Native. These collaborations are part of our DNA as React Native developers. Now, this is early development. We need to massage the octopus quite a bit more. And as we do, we will keep you posted every step of the way. And so indeed, I am looking forward to talk to you soon. And until next time, happy hacking.